G'day, I'm Clayton, this is the Planet Canada YouTube channel and welcome to another Cabinet Vision tutorial. Today we've actually got a pretty cool video for you. It comes from a couple of questions that have been left on some previous videos on a similar topic. The first question is, how can I add a shaker profile to my end panels? And it's the exact same principle for any other door profile or door style that we'd like to see on our end panel. And then in the second question, we're going to talk about how we can create our own standalone end panels to save to our catalogue for our future projects. And the cool thing about this second question is it's going to touch on some more advanced aspects or concepts of Cabinet Vision in a very beginner-friendly way. So if you're new or newish to Cabinet Vision, I think you'll really be able to take advantage of what you learned here. So before we get into it, a great reminder, if you also have some questions that you would like to see answered in a tutorial like this, please feel free to add them down to the comments below. We have a great lineup of content coming over the next several weeks and months, but I'm happy to play favorites. If you've got a good question, I'll happily postpone some of those so that we can get you the answer you need as soon as possible. So let's jump into it. How can we add a shaker profile to our end panels? The first thing I'm going to do is put myself on an equal playing field. I'll close down that job and let's open up a new job together. And it doesn't matter which job properties we use. So we'll just click OK, add a wall so that we've got a place to start working. And what I want you to do is just grab a basic cabinet and add it to your wall. And then we're going to double click on that cabinet so that we can be taken to the cabinet level. Now, in the cabinet level, all these different settings are just relevant for this cabinet. And I need to be in the section view or on the section tab here. On the left-hand side, you'll see this top-down view of my cabinet with the four lines. That red line is telling me what face I'm currently working on. So for instance, if I click on the middle of the face of the cabinet here, it turns blue and these red lines outline it, just like this red line here. So if I would like to add or control my end panel, I can click on this dotted line that represents my right-hand end side. And you'll notice the type is currently set to automatic. We can talk more about this in future videos, but I'll just quickly explain it here. Automatic means Cabinet Vision is super smart. It knows if I've got a filler, an object, a cabinet, or a wall against my cabinet, that end is not seen. I'm probably happy with an unfinished end, and it will choose that automatically. However, if it recognizes that there's a certain gap between my cabinet and that end is seen, it will make that automatically a finished end. However, if we would like to have an end panel that follows the door settings, I'm going to manually change this type to an applied door. And if I click on 3D now, you'll notice that Cabinet Vision has added in this panel here. And it is a door object, which means it's currently following the door settings. The door profile that is on my cabinet is also the door profile here. So if I go to section and then click on properties and doors and drawers, I can change the door profile just for this cabinet. And I'm going to make this say, let's use the square root and click OK. Now, when I go to 3D, you'll notice that automatically my end panel has added in that shaker profile. Let's say, for instance, I don't want my end panel to be identical to my door standards here. So if I click on section, let's just make this a slab again. We'll go doors and drawers. We'll make this a slab. Click OK and OK. So now they're the same. I'm going to show you how you can control the door profile on just that end panel. So we'll go section again. We'll click on the face that we want to work on. And because it's now a door object, if I click on this space, you'll notice it turns blue with the red outline again. And if I double click on the blue, I can now manually control this door style. So if I double click on that, change this to be a square root, click OK. Okay, okay. Now when we go to our 3D view, you'll notice that my end panel is using the door profile that I've chosen. and it's ignoring the door standards of the cabinet. I've essentially told Cabinet Vision that this single part settings are more important for you than the cabinet settings, okay? And that touches on the Cabinet Vision hierarchy, which we've got another video that explains more in depth if you'd like to understand that deeper. Now, if I go return, you'll see I've created our first end panel. But let's say, for instance, I wanted to make a standalone end panel that is following my door settings in my room or in my job. Well, to do that, we need to understand kind of a fundamental truth of Cabinet Vision. And that is, if I go grab a panel to show you, this panel here, and we'll just add in another basic cabinet. So what we need to understand about Cabinet Vision is every single object in that catalog is an assembly. Now, to you and me, this panel is just a single panel, and this is an assembly. But to Cabinet Vision, they're the same thing. This panel just doesn't have a back, a bottom, another end, or a toe. So to create a standalone panel, we essentially have to do what we've done here in our first cabinet and then remove all the other parts. And then we can save that to our catalog so we never have to recreate it again. So grab yourself a cabinet, double click on it to go to the cabinet level. Go to the section view and let's just add in that applied door again. So we've got this panel, which is following the door standards. And now from the section view, if you click on properties and case, let's remove the top and the bottom. And if we click on toe, let's make the toe height 0. So the first thing we've done is remove the top, the bottom, and the toe from our cabinet. If I click on the white space here from the section and face and then delete, Cabinet Vision will remove all of the face and interior parts. Great. And now we're left with another end, an unfinished back, and this nailer by the looks of it, and our right end, sub end. So to remove those, we're going to use the object tree of Cabinet Vision. So if you are familiar with the object tree, I'm going to move myself around. And in the bottom left here, there is these three colored dots in the black line. This is the object tree. So the object tree is essentially a list of all the different parts which make up our cabinet, or all the different cabinets which make up our room, and all of the settings associated with those parts as well. So I have at the moment these parts here, and I need to remove these four and just keep the door opening. So I'm going to click on the finish left end, and you'll notice I've got this little new parameter button. Click on that. And what we're going to do is change the quantity of this object to 0. So keep that at 0, QTY. Okay. And now Cabinet Vision has removed that part from this assembly. I can do the exact same thing with the sub end. So we'll just go through and add the quantity equals 0. Do that on the unfinished back. Quantity equals 0, and then we'll also do that on the nailer, quantity equals 0. And you'll notice that now all I'm left with is this door object material, which is our end panel following the door style. There's one more change we need to make. You'll notice that the face for our cabinet is still at the cabinet width. What we want to do is tell Cabinet Vision that the face width has to now match our parts thickness. So to do that, we're going to create a little equation, a simple equation in our object tree. So what I need to do is click on my door opening. I'm going to click on the DZ just once. And you'll notice I've got this little formula pop up. We're going to right click and copy this. And now we're going to go to our standard base cabinet, which you can see here is the current space that we need to change. And I've got here the 19 and a quarter with the missing space making up the 20. So I can see that my DX is my 20 inches, and I need to make this automatically the thickness of my door object. So I'm going to double click on that, and I'm going to change this to an equation. And I'm just going to control V and paste this setting. So what I'm essentially doing in Cabinet Vision now is I'm telling it that the width of this face needs to be identical to the thickness of my door object or my end panel that we're building. Now, the advantage to this, instead of just putting in a single value, is that now if I change my material or if I change the kind of door I'm using, this space is going to grow or shrink with the thickness of the part automatically. So essentially we're creating a smarter part here and a smarter assembly. So you can click test here to make sure it works. It does, we'll click okay. Might look a bit funky for a minute. If we just click return and click back into it, you'll notice that now Cabinet Vision has automatically aligned those two and we have this single part here that is following the door materials. It's our end panel that we've created. Now you'll notice if I go to my plan, my room, my cabinet, and let's change the door style here to be the square root, and okay, okay, that's all good. And we'll go 3D. So now we have an end panel which is currently following the door standards of our room. Now you could equally go to your plan or elevation, double click on this door, and then manually change the door from the cabinet properties menu to be something else if you didn't want it following the job or the room standard. But once you're happy with that, we can click return. We can go back to our home view, change that. And if I right click and save as, now I can add to my base columns and fillers, and we can go base panel, door, profile. You could name it whatever you want. You could name it shaker if you are saving it with that specific shaker profile. And if you do want to save it to your catalog so it doesn't follow the job or the room, but just the cabinet, you can make sure that you go to advanced, preserves, and you just want to preserve the door applied and door style box here. And click OK, OK, and now it's saved to our catalog, ready to be used in future projects. Now, before I wrap this up, I'm just gonna try and predict maybe some of the extra questions you might have after this. This process is identical for our finished ends as well, but let's just quickly look at how we can create a standalone panel that also keeps the toe height. So to do that, I've got this cabinet here, and I've made this on the side here an applied finished end instead of an applied door. So if we want to create a standalone finished end panel, this is how we do it. And then when I go to remove the supplementary part from the section view, properties, and then toe, when I go to remove the toe, keep the toe height there, but just remove the front recess, the back recess, the left recess, zero out all of these dimensions, and I've made these all unfinished and none. But the point is, all that I'm left with is, in the object tree, these three parts here, the two side toes and the front toe. And I just quantity zero them as well. And then when you've gone through and quantity zeroed all those parts and fixed the equation for the open space, I've now got a finished end panel, which I can save to my catalog that also keeps that toe height value there. And then secondly, if maybe you want to create a finished left end or a finished applied door on the left-hand side, it's the exact same process, except when you go to change or add the applied door or a finished end, do it on the left hand side here as opposed to the right, then go through and remove all those parts and save it to the catalog. And there you go, we're back to where we started. We have our end door object with the shaker profile. We have a cabinet that shows us how to just add that profile just to the door object and not follow the door standard of the cabinet. And we have our standalone door object panel and our standalone finished end panel. So hopefully that's helped, that's made sense. If you have any more questions about this topic, please feel free to add them into the comments below, and we'll see you in the next video.